How often do you procrastinate around everyday things?
I'm a terrible procrastinator. I will put tasks like paperwork off as long as possible. For example, taxes. Every year my taxes, even though I don't do them, I have an accountant do them, they're still filed 2 months late just because I won't take the time to get the paperwork together for him.
How long have you had this?
Again, this is a very long-standing problem. My schoolwork, growing up, I would put off to the last minute, procrastinate because it wasn't something I wanted to do, and then rush to get it done at the last moment.
How does this procrastination impact on you?
It's affected me. I guess I've had to pay penalties on my taxes for years. My bills get paid late because I hate doing the paperwork on those, so I ended up paying more than I really should for my bills.
Once you start a boring task, how often do you get sidetracked so that you don't follow through and finish this kind of task?
Very often. If I take on a task that is really boring, I'll get started, I'll do a little bit of it, and then find something more interesting to do and go off and do that instead. So yeah, I'm forever procrastinating that way.
And how long have you had this procrastination around boring tasks?
Dates back to childhood as well, I'd say. Leaving my assignments to, that's due on Friday and don't start working to it or working on it until Thursday evening.
Are you often irritable, easily frustrated, hot-tempered?
I have a very low frustration tolerance, so I get angry at small things, kind of blow up, flare up, and then it goes away on me, but I do get frustrated easily.
How long have you had this irritability?
That's a long time. I remember having, I guess when I was a child, it was called the temper tantrum. Don't like to call it that as an adult.
So it's been a long-standing
problem. Long-standing, yes.
Are you often an impatient person?
I'm a very impatient person. I don't wait well. If I'm in a store, say, and I'm waiting to get service, I feel the service is bad, I'll just get up and I'll walk out. I won't wait to be served. I don't do lines well. If I have to go driving, I can get very upset with drivers I think are going too slowly, aren't signaling their turns. It always drives me crazy. I get very impatient with people that don't signal and leave me sitting at an intersection when I could have turned.
How long have you had that?
I've had the impatience. It's chronic. It dates, again, right back to my childhood.
Are you often impulsive? In what way are you impulsive?
I can be very impulsive. I'm verbally impulsive first, I guess, where if I feel somebody's not speaking quickly enough or interestingly enough, I'll break in on their sentences. Sometimes I blurt things out that may not be fully connected to the conversation we're having, so I guess that'd be impulsive too. Driving, I can be somewhat impulsive. Again, if somebody's driving too slowly, I can try to get around them, get angry that way. Also, sometimes an impulsive spender. If I see something that I want, I'll buy it and then worry about the budget later.
Are you often inconsistent with activities, work, hobbies?
I'm very inconsistent. I'll take a project on. I'll start it with full enthusiasm, and then interest will fade. I'll just stop working on it. It was the same way in school. I'd have half my marks would be 50s, 60s, and then projects that I enjoyed or subjects I enjoyed I'd have 90s.
Are you often bored easily?
I get bored, like I said, in conversation. If I find somebody's not that interesting, I can kind of fade away. Meetings can be very hard for me, just to hear people talking, going on, and I just kind of lose track of what's going on in the meeting if it's not really interesting.
How long have you had this boredom?
I've been bored for a long time, since I was a kid. It's a teacher droning on would lose me early on in the lesson. I'd be thinking about something else that was going on rather than listening.
And how do you think this has impacted on you?
It hasn't helped me occupationally, because you have to attend meetings, you have to listen, you have to participate, and people can tell when you're not really functioning in a meeting.
Are you often easily distracted?
Yes, I am very easily distracted. I work in an office in a cubicle, so I can hear everything going on around me, and I find it really hard to focus on my work when I can hear you know, my workmate next door talking to his wife on the phone, or somebody else talking about a project they're working on. Just find it hard to focus if there's too much noise or activity going on around me.
How long have you had this distractibility?
This also dates back to childhood. I remember sitting in class, and I'd be sitting by the window, and teacher would be talking at the front, and I'd be looking at the window watching, you know, some of my friends walking by or watching whatever else is going on outside rather than concentrating on the class.
How has this distractibility impacted on you?
Impacted on me, well, educationally first, because I wasn't tuned into what was going on a lot of the times, and then at work, again, I'm not meeting my full potential because I'm distracted about everything going on around the cubicle.
Are you easily preoccupied by your own thoughts?
Yes, I'm very preoccupied. I can, in conversation, if somebody says something interesting, I'll pick up on the fact, I'll start thinking about that and lose track of what the other things we've been talking about. Or for that matter, if they don't say something interesting, I'll just start thinking about something more interesting and I won't hear what they're saying to me at all.
How has this impacted on you?
Socially, it can be awkward because when you're out somewhere and talking to somebody, you should be paying attention. But if your eyes go blank and you're in the middle of a conversation, it's not the best thing.
Are you often disorganized?
I'm terribly disorganized. My house is a big ball of clutter. There's paper everywhere, books, stacks of things, boxes. I moved 3 years ago and still have half my things in boxes.
How long have you had this disorganization?
A long, long time. My locker at school was a real sight to see. Things are buried down there. I'd put something in there in first term and find it when I finished the school year.
How do you stay organized?
I try to stay organized with lists and notes to myself. Lists, I write things down, put them on my computer screen. I'll put them on my fridge at home. I will type myself notes. I'll even phone myself and leave myself voicemails to remind myself of things to be done.
For the symptoms that I've asked you about, how severely have they affected you?
They've had a huge impact on my life. They slowed me down educationally first, and then because I didn't get the education I needed, they held me back occupationally and continue to do so.
How long have you had these symptoms?
The symptoms date back as far as I can remember, so, you know, 6, 7, 8 years old.